Welcome to GCRD Technologies. DevOps interview questions and answers. DevOps, it is related to software testing. Nowadays, software testing is part of DevOps. First, what is DevOps? The word DevOps was coined in 2009. The term was formed by combining development and operations. DevOps is a culture in which communication, integration, and collaboration in the product development lifecycle are emphasized. Thus, it eliminates and silos between software development and operation teams, allowing them to enable rapid and continuous product development. DevOps promotes communication and collaboration between business, development and operation teams. In a way, we are talking about unification. DevOps is not only about tools, but also about involving people and process. DevOps is inspired by the Agile process. DevOps is about automating the development, release and operation processes. DevOps helps in the speed of delivering applications to the end users. DevOps is also about continuous improvement, which helps in learning through feedback. Next, how DevOps different from Agile software development? Agile is a set of values and principles about how to produce IE. Develop software. Example, if you have some ideas and you want to turn those ideas into working software, you can use the Agile values and principles as a way to do that. But that software might only be working on a developer's laptop or in a test environment. You want a way to quickly, easily and repeatably move the software into production infrastructure in a safe and simple way. To do that, you need DevOps tools and techniques. Agile software development methodology focuses on the software development, but DevOps, on the other hand, is responsible for development as well as deployment of the software in the safest and most reliable way possible. Next, what are the key components of DevOps? Continuous integration, continuous testing, continuous delivery, continuous monitoring. Continuous integration, testing, delivery, and monitoring. Next, fourth one. What is continuous integration? CI. Continuous integration is the process of automatically integrating code changes from multiple developers into a shared repository. Automated tests are utilized to verify the assert the additional codes generate no conflict with the existing code base. Ideally, code changes should be merged multiple times a day at every commit with the help of CI tools. Next, what is continuous testing and its benefits? Continuous testing is the practice of applying automated tests yearly, gradually, and adequately in the software delivery pipeline. In a typical CI/CD workflow, builds are released in a small batches. Therefore, it is impractical to manually perform test cases for each delivery. Automated continuous testing eliminates the manual steps and turn them into automated routines, which reduces human effort. That's why automated continuous testing is essential for the DevOps culture. Benefits of continuous testing: ensure the quality and speed of the builds, enables faster software delivery and a continuous feedback mechanism. Next, detect errors as soon as they occur in the system. Next, reduce business risks. Evaluate potential problems before they become real problems. Next, what is continuous delivery? Continuous delivery is an extension of continuous integration, which primarily helps to get the features which the developers are developing out the end users as soon as possible. During this process, it goes through various stages of QA, staging, etc., and then for delivery to the production system. Next, what is continuous monitoring? As the application is developed and deployed, we do need to monitor its performance. Monitoring is also very important, as it might help to uncover the defects which might not have been detected earlier. Next, what are the popular DevOps tools? Popular DevOps tools are Git, G-I-T, Git, version control system tool. Next, Jenkins, continuous integration tool. Next, Selenium, continuous testing tool. Next, Puppet, Chef, Ansible, they are configuration management and deployment tools. Next, Nagios, continuous monitoring tool. Next, Docker, containerization tool. These are the popular tools. Other tools also available in the market. Next, how do DevOps tools work together? Developers develop the code, and the source code is managed by version control system tools like Git, Git, etc. Next step, developers send this code to the Git repository, and any changes made in the code is committed to this repository. Next, Jenkins pulls this code from the repository using Git plugin and build it using tools like ANT, Ant, or Maven. Next, configuration management tools like Puppet deploys and provisions testing environment, and then Jenkins releases this code on the test environment, on which testing is done using tools like Selenium. Next, once the code is tested, Jenkins send it for deployment on the production server. Next, after deployment, it is continuously monitored by tools like Nagios. Next, Docker containers provides testing environment to test the build features. Next, explain the typical roles involved in DevOps. DevOps architect, the leader who is responsible for the entire DevOps process. Next, DevOps engineer, the person should be experienced with Agile SCM, Software Configuration Management, SCM or Version Control. Next, CI, CD, Continuous Integration, Continuous Delivery, and setting up automation tools for the same. Infrastructure automation and database management skills. Any developer who has skills in coding or scripting and has the acumen to get into deployment or system admin can qualify for the role of a DevOps engineer. Next, what is a version control system? Version control system, VCS, is a software that helps software developers to work together and maintain a complete history of their work. Some of the features of VCS as follows: allow developers to work simultaneously, does not allow overwriting on each other changes. Next, maintain the history of every version. Next, what is Docker? Docker is a containerization technology that packages your application and all its dependencies together in the form of containers to ensure that your application works seamlessly in any environment. Containerization tool, Docker. Next, what are the core operations of DevOps? Core operations of DevOps are unit testing, packaging, code coverage, code developing, configuration, orchestration, provisioning, and deployment. Next, name a few branching strategies used in DevOps. Feature branching, task branching, and release branching. Next, which cloud platforms can be used for the successful DevOps implementation? Cloud platforms that can be used for the successful DevOps implementation are Google Cloud, Amazon Web Services, next, Microsoft Azure. Next, what are the benefits of DevOps, development and operations? Benefits of DevOps are, first one, speed. Move at high velocity so you can innovate for customers faster, adapt to changing markets better, and grow more efficient at driving business results. The DevOps model enables your developers and operation teams to achieve these results. Next, rapid delivery. Increase the frequency and pace of releases so you can innovate and improve your product faster. The quicker you can release new features and fix bugs, the faster you can respond to your customer needs and build competitive advantage. Next, continuous integration and continuous delivery are practices that automate the software release process from build to deploy. Next, reliability. Ensure the quality of application updates and infrastructure changes so you can reliably deliver at a more rapid pace while maintaining a positive experience for end users. Use practices like continuous integration and continuous delivery to test that each change is functional and safe. Monitoring and logging practices help you stay informed for performance in real time. Next, scale. Operate and manage your infrastructure and development processes at scale. Automation and consistency helps you manage complex or changing systems efficiently and with reduced risk. Next, improved collaboration. Build more effective teams under a DevOps culture model which emphasizes values such as ownership and accountability. Developers and operation teams collaborate closely, share many responsibilities, and combine their workflows. This reduces inefficiencies and saves time. Next, last one, security. move quickly while retaining control and preserving compliance. You can adopt a DevOps model without sacrificing security by using automated compliance policies, fine-grained controls, and configuration management techniques. This is about DevOps interview questions and answers. Thank you.